This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Microsoft Hyper-V, codenamed Viridian and formerly known as Windows Server Virtualization, is a native hypervisor. It can create virtual machines on x86-64 systems running Windows starting with Windows 8. Hyper-V supersedes Windows Virtual PC as the hardware virtualization component of the client editions of Windows NT. A server computer running Hyper-V can be configured to expose individual virtual machines to one or more networks. Hyper-V was first released alongside Windows Server 2008, and has been available without charge for all the Windows Server and some client operating systems since Hyper-V is also available on the Xbox One, in which it would launch both Xbox OS and Windows 10 Contents 1 History 11 Hyper-V Server 2 Architecture 3 System Requirements 31 Microsoft Hyper-V Server 4 Supported Guests 41 Linux Support 42 Windows Server 2012-5 VHD compatibility with Virtual Server 2005 and Virtual PC 2004-2007-6 limitations 61 audio 62 optical drives pass through 63 graphics issues on the host 64 live migration 65 degraded performance for Windows XP VMs 66 NIC teaming 67 administration tools 68 VTX handling 7 client operating systems 8 Windows Server 2012 9 Windows Server 2012 R2 10 competitors 11 see also 12 references 13 further reading 14 external links history a beta version of Hyper-V was shipped with certain x86-64 editions of Windows Server 2008 the finalized version was released on June 26, 2008 and was delivered through Windows Update Hyper-V has since been released with every version of Windows Server Microsoft provides Hyper-V through two channels, part of Windows, Hyper-V is an optional component of Windows Server 2008 and later it is also available in x64 SCUS of Pro and Enterprise editions of Windows 8, Windows 81 and Windows 10 Hyper-V Server. It is a freeware edition of Windows Server with limited functionality and Hyper-V component Hyper-V Server Hyper-V Server 2008 was released on October 1, 2008. It consists of Windows Server 2008 Server Core and Hyper-V Role. Other Windows Server 2008 roles are disabled, and there are limited Windows services Hyper-V Server 2008 is limited to a command line interface used to configure the host OS, physical hardware, and software. A menu-driven CLI interface and some freely downloadable script files simplify configuration. In addition, Hyper-V Server supports remote access via remote desktop connection. However, administration and configuration of the host OS and the guest virtual machines is generally done over the network, using either Microsoft Management Consoles on another Windows computer or System Center Virtual Machine Manager. This allows much easier point-and-click configuration and monitoring of the Hyper-V Server. Hyper-V Server 2008 R2, an edition of Windows Server 2008 R2, was made available in September 2009 and includes Windows PowerShell V2 for greater CLI control. Remote access to Hyper-V Server requires CLI configuration of network interfaces and Windows Firewall. Also using a Microsoft Vista PC to administer Hyper-V Server 2008 R2 is not fully supported. Architecture Hyper-V Architecture Hyper-V implements isolation of virtual machines in terms of a partition. A partition is a logical unit of isolation, supported by the hypervisor, in which each guest operating system executes a hypervisor instance has to have at least one parent partition. Running a supported version of Windows Server 2008 and later the virtualization stack runs in the parent partition and has direct access to the hardware devices. The parent partition then creates the child partitions which host the guest OS's. A parent partition creates child partitions using the Hypercall API, which is the application programming interface exposed by Hyper-V, not in citation given. A child partition does not have access to the physical processor, nor does it handle its real interrupts. Instead, it has a virtual view of the processor and runs in guest virtual address, which, depending on the configuration of the hypervisor, might not necessarily be the entire virtual address space depending on VM configuration. Hyper-V may expose only a subset of the processors to each partition. The hypervisor handles the interrupts to the processor, and redirects them to the respective partition using a logical synthetic Synthetic Interrupt Controller SYNIC Hyper-V can hardware accelerate the address translation of guest virtual address spaces by using second-level address translation provided by the CPU, referred to as EPT on Intel and RVI formerly NPT on AMD. Child partitions do not have direct access to hardware resources, but instead have a virtual view of the resources. In terms of virtual devices, any request to the virtual devices is redirected via the VM bus to the devices in the parent partition, which will manage the requests. The VM bus is a logical channel which enables inter-partition communication. The response is also redirected via the VM bus if the devices in the parent partition are also virtual devices. It will be redirected further until it reaches the parent partition, where it will gain access to the physical devices. Parent partitions run a virtualization service provider VSP, which connects to the VM bus and handles device access requests from child partitions. Child partition. Virtual devices internally run a virtualization service client VSC, which redirect the request to VSPs in the parent partition via the VM bus. This entire process is transparent to the guest OS. Virtual devices can also take advantage of a Windows Server Virtualization feature, named Enlightened I/O, for storage, networking and graphics subsystems, among others. Enlightened I/O is specialized virtualization-aware implementation of high-level communication protocols like SCSI to take advantage of VM bus directly, that allows bypassing any device emulation layer. This makes the communication more efficient, but requires the guest OS to support Enlightened I/O. Currently only the following operating systems support Enlightened I/O, allowing them therefore to run faster as guest operating systems under Hyper-V than other operating systems that need to use slower emulated hardware: Windows Server 2008 and later Windows Vista and later Linux with a 34 or later kernel free BSD system requires. See also, Windows Server 2008 section. Host operating system, to install the Hyper-V role, Windows Server 2008, Windows Server 2008 R2 Standard, Enterprise or Datacenter Edition, Windows Server 2012 Standard or Datacenter Edition, Windows 8 or 81 Pro or Enterprise Edition, or Windows 10 Pro, Education or Enterprise Edition, is required. Hyper-V is only supported on x86-64 variants of Windows. It can be installed regardless of whether the installation is a full or core installation processor. An x86-64 processor hardware-assisted virtualization support. This is available in processors that include a virtualization option, specifically, Intel VT or AMD Virtualization. AMD V, formerly codenamed Pacifica, an NX-bit compatible CPU must be available, and hardware data execution prevention DEP must be enabled, although this is not an official requirement. Windows Server 2008 R2 and a CPU with second-level address translation support are recommended. For workstations, second-level address translation is a mandatory requirement for Hyper-V in Windows 8. Memory minimum 2. Server for the non-R2 version and Microsoft Hyper-V Server 2008 R2. Microsoft Hyper-V Server is built with components of Windows and has a Windows Server Core user experience. None of the other roles of Windows Server are available in Microsoft Hyper-V Server. This version supports up to 64. Hyper-V, Standard, Datacenter x64 Windows Server 2012-1-4. Hyper-V, Standard, Datacenter x64 Windows Home Server 2011-1-4. Standard x64 Windows Server 2008 R2 SP11-4. Web, Standard, Enterprise, Datacenter x64 Windows Server 2008 SP21-4. Web, Standard, Enterprise, Datacenter IA32, x86, x64. Windows Server 2003 R2 SP31-2. Web, Standard, Enterprise, Datacenter IA32, x86, x64. Windows 2000 SP41 Professional, Server, Advanced Server x86, IA32. Windows 10-1-4 Home, Professional, Enterprise x64. Windows 7-1-4 Professional, Enterprise, Ultimate x86, x64. Windows Vista 1-4 Business, Enterprise, Ultimate x86, x64. Windows XP SP31-2 Professional x86, IA64, x64. SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 10 SP4 or 11 SP1 SP31-4 N.A. IA32, x64. Red Hat Enterprise Linux 55-70-1-4 N.A. IA32, x64. CentOS 55-70-1-4. NAEA 32, x64 Ubuntu 1204-1404-1 4 NAEA 32, x64 Debian 7.0-1-4 NAEA 32, x64 Oracle Linux 6.4-1-4 Red Hat compatible kernel EA 32, x64 Windows Server 2012 is supported and runs only on a host system Windows Server 2008 R2 RTM or SP1, with a hotfix applied Web Edition does not have an x64 version. Fedora 8 or 9 are unsupported, however, they have been reported to run. Third-party support for FreeBSD 82 and later guests is provided by a partnership between NetApp and Citrix. This includes both emulated and paravirtualized modes of operation, as well as several Hyper-V integration services. Windows 10 Home supports Hyper-V, but has limited memory support up to a max of 8. February 2008, Red Hat and Microsoft signed a virtualization pact for hypervisor interoperability with their respective server operating systems, to enable Red Hat Enterprise Linux 5 to be officially supported on Hyper-V Linux support in July 2009. Microsoft submitted Hyper-V drivers to the kernel, which improve the performance of virtual Linux guest systems in a Windows-hosted environment. Microsoft was forced to submit the code when it was discovered that Microsoft had incorporated a Hyper-V network driver with GPL-licensed components statically linked to closed-source binaries. Hyper-V provides basic virtualization support for Linux guests out-of-the-box. Paravirtualization support is, however, available by installing the Linux integration components or Satori input VSC drivers. On July 20, 2009, Microsoft submitted these drivers for inclusion in the Linux kernel under the terms of the GPL, so that kernels from 2632 may include inbuilt Hyper-V paravirtualization support. Windows Server 2012 Hyper-V in Windows Server 2012 and Windows Server 2012 R2 changes the support list above as follows. Windows 8 with up to 32. Minimum supported version of CentOS is 60. Minimum supported version of Red Hat Enterprise Linux is 57. Maximum number of supported CPUs for Windows Server and Linux operating system is increased from 4 to 64. VHD compatibility with Virtual Server 2005 and Virtual PC 2004-2007. Hyper-V, like Microsoft Virtual Server and Windows Virtual PC, saves each guest OS to a single virtual hard disk file with the extension VHD. HD, except in Windows 8 and Windows Server 2012 where it can be the newer VHDX. This file contains the entire guest OS, though other files can also be configured to allow undo information, etc. Older VHD files from Virtual Server 2005 and Virtual PC 2004-2007 can be copied and used by Hyper-V, but any old virtual machine integration software equivalents of Hyper-V integration services for other virtualization software must be removed from the virtual machine after the migrated guest OS is configured and started using Hyper-V. The guest OS will detect changes to the virtual hardware installing Hyper-V integration services, installs 5 services to improve performance, at the same time adding the new guest video and network card drivers. Consequently, Windows guests may require reactivation limitations audio. Hyper-V does not virtualize audio hardware before Windows 81 and Windows Server 2012 R2. It was possible to work around this issue by connecting to the virtual machine with remote desktop connection over a network connection and use its audio redirection feature. Windows 81 and Windows Server 2012 R2 add the enhanced session mode, which provides redirection without a network connection. Optical drives pass through. Optical drives virtualized in the guest VM are read only officially. Hyper-V does not support the host/root operating system's optical drives to pass through in guest VMs. As a result, burning to disks, audio CDs, video CD, DVD video playback are not supported. However, a workaround exists using the ISCSI protocol. Setting up an ISCSI target on the host machine with the optical drive can then be talked to by the standard Microsoft ISCSI initiator. Microsoft produces their own ISCSI target software, or alternative third-party products can be used. Graphics issues on the host on CPUs without second-level address translation. Installation of most WDDM accelerated graphics drivers on the primary OS will cause a dramatic drop in graphic performance. This occurs because the graphics drivers access memory in a pattern that causes the translation lookaside buffer to be flushed frequently. In Windows Server 2008, Microsoft officially supported Hyper-V only with the default VGA drivers, which do not support Windows Aero, higher resolutions, rotation, or multi-monitor display. However, unofficial workarounds were available in certain cases. Older non-WDDM graphics drivers sometimes did not cause performance issues, though these drivers did not always install smoothly on Windows Server. Intel integrated graphics cards did not cause TLB flushing even with WDDM drivers. Some NVIDIA graphics drivers did not experience problems so long as Windows Aero was turned off and no 3D applications were running in Windows Server 2008 R2. Microsoft added support for second-level address translation to Hyper-V since SLAT is not required to run Hyper-V with Windows Server. The problem will continue to occur if a non-SLAT CPU is used with accelerated graphics drivers. However, SLAT is required to run Hyper-V on client versions of Windows 8 Live Migration. Hyper-V in Windows Server 2008 does not support live migration of guest VMs, where live migration is defined as maintaining network connections and uninterrupted services during VM migration between physical hosts. Instead, Hyper-V on Server 2008 Enterprise and Data Center Edition supports quick migration, where a guest VM is suspended on one host and resumed on another host. This operation happens in the time it takes to transfer the active memory of the guest VM over the network from the first host to the second host. However, with the release of Windows Server 2008 R2, live migration is supported with the use of cluster shared volume CSVs. This allows for failover of an individual VM as opposed to the entire host having to failover. It seems that when a node Hyper-V server, not a VM, fails, then each VM running on the failed node may migrate to other live nodes independently of other VMs on the same LUN running on other nodes that share the LUN with the failed node. In Hyper-V, we are clustering the Hyper-V nodes, not the VMs. See also cluster shared volumes. Windows Server 2012's implementation of Hyper-V version 30 introduced many new features to increase VM mobility, including the ability to execute simultaneous live migrations. Windows Server 2008 R2 only supported live migrating a single VM at a time, significantly increasing the time required to carry administrative tasks, such as draining a node for scheduled maintenance. The only real limit factor here is hardware and network bandwidth available. Windows Server 2012 also supports a new shared nothing live migration option, where no traditional shared storage is required in order to complete a migration, also referred to as live system migration. A shared nothing live migration will move a running VM and its storage from one Hyper-V host to another without any perceived downtime. Live migration between different host OS versions is not possible, although this is soon to be addressed in Windows Server 2012 R2. Windows Server 2012 also introduced the ability to use simple SMB shares as a shared storage option in conjunction with the new scale-out file services role in Server 2012 for highly available environments, alleviating the need for expensive SANs. This is particularly useful for low-budget environments, without the need to sacrifice performance due to the many new improvements to the SMB3 stack. Windows Server 2012 will fully support the live migration of VMs running on SMB shares, whether it be a live or live system migration. Hyper-V under Windows Server 2012 also supports the ability to migrate a running VM storage, whereby an active virtual machine storage can be moved from one infrastructure to another without the VM's workload being affected, further reducing the limitations associated with VM mobility. With the introduction of Windows Server 2012 R2, SMB30 was introduced as a transport option for live migration, either between clustered or non-clustered virtualization hosts. This enables Hyper-V live migration to leverage the additional benefits that SMB30 brings, such as SMB multi-channel and SMB direct in conjunction with RDMA NICs for increased live migration performance. Degraded performance for Windows XP VMs. Windows XP frequently accesses CPU's APIC task priority register TPR when interrupt request level changes, causing a performance degradation when running as guests on Hyper-V. Microsoft has fixed this problem in Windows Server 2003 and later. Intel adds TPR virtualization flex priority to VTX on Intel Core 2 stepping E onwards to alleviate this problem. AMD has a similar feature on AMD V but uses a new register for the purpose. This however means that the guest has to use different instructions to access this new register. AMD provides a driver called AMD V optimization driver that has to be installed on the guest to do that. NIC teaming, network card teaming, or link aggregation isn't supported if the NIC manufacturer supplied drivers servers support NIC teaming, however, Windows Server 2012 and thus the version of Hyper-V included with it supports software NIC teaming administration tools. Hyper-V management tools are not compatible with Windows Vista Home Basic or Home Premium or Windows 7 Home Premium, Home Basic or Starter. Hyper-V 2012 can only be managed by Windows 8, Windows Server 2012 or their successors VTX. Handling the VTX x86 virtualization feature is used by the Hyper-V and not available for other solutions as long as Hyper-V is installed, if for instance the Android Studio or Microsoft Visual Studio Community HAXM Android Device Emulator Virtual Machine is needed, then Hyper-V must be removed as a Windows feature in order for the former to work. Hyper-V can be installed by default, in which case the user must remove the Hyper-V feature before using another application which requires VTX client operating system's 64-bit SCUS of Windows 8 Pro or Enterprise, or later, come with a special version Hyper-V called Client Hyper-V. Windows Server 2012. Windows Server 2012 introduced many new features in Hyper-V. Hyper-V Extensible Virtual Switch Network Virtualization Multi-Tenancy Storage Resource Pools VHDX disk format supporting virtual hard disks as large as 64. Windows Server 2012 R2. With Windows Server 2012 R2, Microsoft introduced another set of new features: shared virtual hard disk storage, quality of service virtual machine generation, enhanced session mode, automatic virtual machine activation, competitors VMware, independent hypervisor and virtualization creator, also still compatible with older x86 systems without virtualization extensions, Citrix, thin client systems provider Oracle VM Server for x86 Parallels, Inc., for Mac QEMU, Open Source VirtualBox, Open Source Xen, Open Source OpenStack, Open Source KVM, Open Source. See also comparison of platform virtualization software features new to Windows 8. Hashtag virtualization virtual disk image Microsoft open specification promise virtual private server references caret Microsoft to ship Windows Server 2008, over time, in 8 flavors. Retrieved 13 November 2007. Caret AB server virtualization features Microsoft retrieved October 5, 2012. Retrieved 2 March 2010. Caret available today, free BSD support for Windows Server Hyper-V. Openness at Microsoft 9 August 2012. Retrieved 25 May 2014. Caret Hyper-V overview TechNet Microsoft retrieved October 5, 2012. Caret Finn, Aiden, Windows Server 2012 Hyper-V does not require SLAT EPT, NPT capable processors. Configure Hyper-V tools for remote administration. TechNet Microsoft retrieved 7 October 2012. TechNet Microsoft.com retrieved 26 April 2016. Official blog Virtualization Fabric Design Considerations Guide Hyper-V on Microsoft TechNet Benchmarking Hyper-V on Windows Server 2008 R2x64 Hyper-V Architecture Hyper-V Architecture German Hyper-V CPU Requirements German Details about Cluster Shared Volume German VE Virtualization Software Comparison of Platform Virtualization Software Hardware Virtualization Hypervisors Native ADIOS CP, CMS Hyper-V KVM Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization LDAMs, Oracle VM Server for Spark LinkSecure Simon VMware ESXi VMware vSphere vCloud VMware Infrastructure Xen Oracle VM Server for x86 ZenClient Xtratum Z, VM Hosted Specialized Basilisk 2. Beehive Box Cooperative Linux DOSBox DOSEMUL4 Linux Mac on Linux Mac on Mac PCEM Sheepshaver SIMH Windows on Windows Virtual DOS Machine Win4 Lin Independent Microsoft Virtual Server Parallels Workstation Parallels Desktop for Mac Parallels Server for Mac Pair PC QEMU VirtualBox Virtual Iron VMware Fusion VMware Player VMware Server VMware Workstation Windows Virtual PC Tools Ginetti Overt Virtual Machine Manager OS Level Virtualization C Groups Based Core OS LMCTFY Linux V Server LXC Docker OpenVS FreeBSD Jail iCore Virtual Accounts Kubernetes Linux Namespaces Solaris Containers Workload Partitions Desktop Virtualization Citrix ZenApp Citrix ZenDesktop Remote Desktop Services VMware Horizon View Application Virtualization Cedo Citrix Zenapp Dalvik InstallFree Microsoft App V Remote Desktop Services Spoon Symantec Workspace Virtualization VMware ThinApp ZeroVM Network Virtualization Distributed Overlay Virtual Ethernet Dove NVGRE Open vSwitch Virtual Security Switch Virtual Extensible LAN VXLAN. See also, List of emulators VE Microsoft Windows Components Management Tools CMDEXE Control Panel Applets Device Manager Disk Cleanup Disk Defragmenter Driver Verifier Event Viewer iExpress Management Console NetSH Recovery Console Resource Monitor Scan Disk Settings App Sysprep System Configuration System File Checker System Information System Policy Editor System Restore Task Manager Windows Error Reporting Windows Installer PowerShell Windows Update Windows Insider WinRE WMI Apps